Good evening, all. Good. Welcome to Bridgewater State University for this historic event. Before we get started, we want to pay tribute to both nations with the singing of our national anthem, the anthem of the United States, and also the anthem of Cape Verde. So I welcome Candida Rose forward to do that.
May I ask everyone to stand, please?
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bomb bursting that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Canta, meu irmão, que a liberdade hino e o homem a certeza com dignidade ter semente no pó da ilha nua na despenhadeira da vida, esperança é do tamanho de mar que nos abraças, sentinelas de mares e ventos, perseverante entre estrelas e o Atlântico, entoa o cântico de liberdade. Canta, irmão, canta, meu irmão, que a liberdade hino e o homem é a certeza.
Obrigado.
Thank you, Candida, for those lovely renditions of the United States National Anthem and Cape Verde National Anthem. Tonight we gather to celebrate the launching of the Pedro Peace Institute for Cape Verdean Studies. For those of you who do not know, the Institute is the only institute in the world dedicated to preserving and advancing Cape Verdean culture and its relationship to the world. I'm honored to be here as your MC. In Cape Verdean terms, I would tell you, my Yanomi de Igreja, that means my church name, is Miguel Gomes Jr. Yanomi de Casa, okay? You know your street name? It's my Gomes. And for my one of my mothers who's in the house, I'm still my E. It's an honor and a privilege to be serving as your master of ceremonies. It's also wonderful to see such beautiful colleagues, family, friends, and supporters of BSU and Cape Verde. It is so wonderful that I'm going to take a privilege tonight. But I have no authority to do so.
Doesn't matter.
That's right, my president. He said it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter to me anymore because I'm retired and you're funny. Tonight, for all of you who are not Cape Verdean, what I'm going to do on this evening is bestow upon you the honor of being Cape Verdeans for the night. I have three prime ministers with me here tonight. On your way out, you can get your passport. At this point, the only thing that stands between you and a delicious dinner is me. So what I'm going to do is leave the podium. I welcome you to have a wonderful meal, and I'll shortly return to the podium. Bon appetit. Rather than waiting to the end of the program to offer thanks to so many people, I really would like to take this opportunity. I hope you all enjoyed the meal. Obviously, it's still being served dessert and coffee. Part of the meal was good old Cape Verdean style, family style. So I hope you enjoyed that. So we will continue. Bridgewater is all about partners. One of our greatest partners is our food service provider, Sodexo. They always are hiding in the back and doing whatever, but tonight we're going to bring them up front. I'm just going to mention a couple of names. And for you who understand Creole kind of cuisine, so we have some secret weapons to make the kachuka. Raise your hand, the kachuka. And obviously we have some of the other staff, but I would just like to point out a person that's always been a great, great source of assistance to us, Gary Boothby. Gary, raise your hand. Angela Mallory, who none of this is possible without her. Where's the head chef, Art? Where's Art?
Sorry, he had to leave.
Art had to leave because he didn't know things were going to come out right. But Art did a wonderful job, and the rest of the Sodexo staff. Let's give them a warm round. I'm going to move quickly, but I don't want to be so quick that I don't pay special attention and special thanks to some folks. We don't want this to turn into a Cape Verdean event, meaning that we'll be here for breakfast. So we're going to move a little bit, okay? First of all, some years ago, Dr. Dela Molafari charged a group of us to come up with the notion and the idea of an institute. He said, please do this, come back to me, and when I look at it, I'll tell you if I like it or not. If it's not good, go back and do it again. So we went out and we did this, and the folks that served on that committee, Joao Vicente Santos, Vanessa Brito, Galen Henderson, our now president, Fred Clark, my good friend, old friend, Brian Baldwin, Donna Thomas, Donaldo Macino, Amina Pilgrim, gosh, she's like my daughter when I mess up her name, Marlene Rodriguez, and Kevin Andrews. Can we give them a round of applause? I will ask you to go to the back of your program to look at the folks who served on the launch committee. I'm not going to read their names, but I think that it is noteworthy that these folks worked long and hard to actually get this program going, and they did a wonderful job. For the ones who do all this event, we transform all of these venues in hours. Those folks worked tirelessly to do that, and that's Lindy McQuaid and Colleen Delmore. So let's give them a round of applause. And for those of you who called early to make your reservation, even those who called late, as late as 11 o'clock this morning so they could be here, the folks who did a wonderful job in marshaling all that for us are here. And I can't tell you, if I didn't have Debbie, who's scared, where's Debbie? Where are you, Debbie? Stand up, Debbie, I don't see you. Where's Debbie? Where's Debbie? Here's Debbie. And Luisa Almeida. Where's Luisa? So I thank you for that. When we were putting this event together, in one of the committee meetings, something was said to me that really, it really struck me. And it was Joao and Luisa, who said, you know what? We started at Bridgewater and we started this institute 2 years ago. This is the official kickoff, but we started the institute 2 years ago. And they said, you know something, Mike? We could not have been successful here if we didn't have the support of two staff members. They made everything easy for us. We often say at Bridgewater, Bridgewater is a special place because it has special people. And that's what makes it run. Two of those special people are here tonight. Two of those people helped immensely to get this institute running, to actually show both Luisa and Joao the ropes. And I would like for us to give them a resounding applause. They are Laura Machado and Kerry Weed. I tell you, can't fire me. I'd like to take this opportunity and taking this opportunity, most guys say, you know, I can do it all myself. But you know what? No, we can't, guys. Because behind every good man is a great woman. So it gives me great pleasure to introduce our First Lady, BSU's First Lady, Kerry Coolidge Clark. That's our First Lady. Now we'll get to the rest. There are many things I can say about BSU's 12th president. Simply stated, what you see is what you get, and much more. BSU has 42 international engagements, and for Fred, one of the most important, and he said this publicly, is Cape Verde.
He has made 7 trips to Cape Verde, 1 short of becoming an honorary citizen. For me, he is one of the most dedicated, sincere, and truly genuine people. I've had the pleasure to work with him, and it's a pleasure to call him my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, BSU's President Fred Clark.
Thank you very much, Mike. And we call him Uncle Mike on this campus. Uncle Mike, and he just saved me with my wife because I wasn't sure I was going to remember to mention her, so he just made sure that I was going to be in good shape no matter what. So, good evening, everyone. I want to welcome everyone here on behalf of our students, our faculty, our staff, our trustees. It is such a pleasure to host all of you here at Bridgewater State University. I have the pleasure to introduce a few very special guests who are with us tonight. I want to start with a special welcome to Commandant Pedro Pérez, former Prime Minister and past President of Cape Verde, who our institute is named after. And we heard the President speak last night, and being in the audience, I felt like I was in the presence with the Cape Verdean equivalent of George Washington. Commandant, thank you so much for being here. He's not lost. He is connected deeply to the Cape Verdean community and to this institution here just before I stand up. I know the Director General of Higher Education for the country of Cape Verde is here with us as well. Jose Mario Correa as well, I think he is here in the audience. Thank you very much for coming. Hercules Cruz, who is the new, I understand, Consul General of Cape Verde. I haven't yet had a chance to engage with Hercules, but thank you so much. We have a great partnership with the Consul and the Consul General as well. So thank you very much. I also want to mention, we have a representative here representing Governor Charlie Baker, and I want to welcome him. And he's out quite a few nights a week. We're talking out front to Hidari Gale, who's Governor Baker's community liaison. Thank you so much for being here. And I have a few of my colleagues here. I want to just ask them to be recognized. I have the president, my colleague, President of Westfield State University, Ramon Garcia, who's here with us as well. Please. Mr. Brody, the Executive Officer of the State University Council of Presidents, the job I had at one point in time, is here with us as well. Thank you, Minister, for being here. And then finally, Jack Sprague, my good friend, President of Bristol Community College, one of our closest friends in higher education. Jack, thank you for coming. I want to extend, on behalf of the entire campus community, our gratitude to the launch committee for organizing the gala tonight. We deeply appreciate our founding members, Brenna Malevi, Vice President Brenna Malevi. We'll have more to say about them a little bit later. Thank you so much for supporting this important initiative at Bridgewater. And I also want to thank Sodexo for your continuing kindness in donating this dinner to this effort as well. So I have a couple of comments. I'll be a little bit serious, and then I'll stop. But just a few comments for me, and that is that the United States and this region of Southeastern Mass have been blessed by the immigrant experience. Courageous people traveling long distances to start a new life. The immigrant experience is one of the foundations of this great country. We are proud. We are proud to embrace the millions who have come here to live and work, study, and in the process have made this country strong, prosperous, and so wonderfully diverse. We have been truly blessed by the arrival on our shores of those courageous people from Cape Verde. From Rava, Fogo, São Vicente, Santiago, Sal, Mayo, Santa Antonia, Etau, Boa Vista, San Nicolau, they journeyed to a new home in America, and especially in this beautiful corner of Massachusetts. They came to work on whaling boats to New Bedford. Others came to work in the cranberry bogs of Wareham, while others worked in textile mills of Fall River. Over time, they started their own construction companies, purchased fishing boats, opened grocery stores, and in at least one case became a university president. They are a vibrant part of the American dream. They gave our region a unique identity, a flourishing culture, and a loving spirit. And these hardworking and determined Cape Verdeans never forgot their roots or the islands that they may have come from off the coast of Africa. The people of Cape Verde always knew what mattered to them was family, religion, art, poetry, music, and food. The people of Cape Verde have immense national pride, endless smiles, and confidence that the future will be bright. When independence and self-determination came in 1975, led by our distinguished guest tonight, former President Pedro Pires, Cape Verde faced new challenges of national development. Under the guidance of President Pires and future prime ministers who are with us tonight, and with that indomitable spirit of the people of Cabo Verde and the diaspora in southeastern Massachusetts, they built a new country that prospered and became a shining example of how freedom and democracy can accomplish great goals. We at Bridgewater State recognize the boundless potential of Cape Verde. And under the leadership of President Emeritus Daniel Olafaria, who began to form what would become a truly vibrant and meaningful partnership for us. Working closely with the Cape Verdean government in 2002, BSU helped the country obtain a Millennial Challenge grant from the U.S. government that was instrumental in helping to form the University of Cape Verde, UCV. Bridgewater State followed up that grant with a protocol of cooperation in 2007. That protocol led to important collaborations and initiatives in areas of training, student exchange, investment opportunities, educational programs, and faculty-led tours. As BSU built this partnership over the years, we committed faculty and staff who worked tirelessly to help students and government officials to deepen that partnership and that relationship. And I would like to recognize some of those key advocates of a vibrant and successful partnership with Cape Verde. Of course, and I'll talk about him later, our president, our former president, President Artis Dannemora-Farrar. He has been the guiding force in all of those partnership initiatives that I've mentioned. He has shown the vision, the energy, the humanity to do whatever is possible to work with the Cape Verdean people. All of us, from Cape Verde and from BSU, owe Dana a tremendous debt of gratitude for his continuing contributions to this partnership. But there were other major participants in this grand partnership as well. People like Uncle Mike Gomes, Harold Tavares, Dave Almeida, Ambassador Vern Penner, and many others who turned ideas into reality and made the collaboration the foundation of this relationship. Those at BSU who helped to advance this relationship with Cape Verde were always guided by the importance of mutual respect, cooperation, and friendship, and were committed to building human capacity, opportunities, and developing leaders of the future. Now the next step in this partnership is tonight's official launching of the Pedro Pérez Institute for Cape Verdean Studies, headed by the distinguished scholar who we're so proud of, Dr. Joel Rosa. The Institute is the first, as you heard, of its kind in the United States and is dedicated to opening the world to the contributions of the people of that great country. The Institute's mission will be multidimensional. It will serve as a research and programmatic center, an outreach entity, and a source of greater understanding of Cape Verdean history, language, culture, and social life. The Institute will bring to the BSU campus scholars and experts who will study and contribute their work to expand the knowledge of Cape Verdean experience in Massachusetts. The Institute is just another example of BSU's commitment to Cape Verde, its history, its people, and its future. Cape Verde holds a very special place in the heart and spirit of BSU. We are very proud to have played a small role in Cape Verde's development, and you have my word as the 12th president of Bridgewater State University that we will continue to do so in the coming years. So now let us begin a new chapter in this important partnership and friendship as we officially launch the Pedro Pérez Institute for Cape Verde Studies here at Bridgewater State University. Obrigado.
Cape Verde has a long history It's a storied history and a complicated one, and for many people here in Massachusetts, it is an important part of our history and our culture. And I think in many ways, Bridgewater's decision to head down this road and to create this institute and to make it possible for so many people who are part of that joint heritage of the Commonwealth of Mass and Cape Verde to be able to put those two together and to discuss them freely in an academic environment is a great opportunity for us all. I look forward to the success of the university and of the institute. Again, I'm very sorry I can't be with you. And I hope you all have a wonderful evening, and we look forward to learning and growing together into the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you, President Clark. Thank you, Governor. At this time, I'd like to bring to the podium a person who's worked tirelessly for Cape Verde over four decades. He served as Prime Minister for 9 years, nine of the 41 years of Cape Verde's independence, and currently he's about to get sworn in as the Ambassador to the United States from Cape Verde, the Honorable Carlos Vega.
And is in fact one of the largest Cape Verdean communities evento de hoje, lançamento de Instituto de Estudos Cabo-Verdianos Pedro Pires, é mais uma continuação dessa história.
And this launching of the Institute is a continuation of that history.
Ele é um importante marco, mais um importante marco, e mais um ponto na relação, grande relação de amizade que existe entre Bridgewater State University e Cabo Verde.
And this is a very important marker in the relationship that exists between Bridgewater State University and Cape Verde.
E é também um ponto, mais um ponto, bridge, ponto. Então não tem mais um ponto.
And so this is yet another bridge.
Yes. Okay. É mais um ponto a adicionar a centenas de jovens cabo-verdianos formados nessa universidade.
And it's another bridge that hundreds of students, Cape Verdean students, have graduated from this university.
Programa IA. Funciona como facilitador de relações entre outras instituições americanas e Cabo Verde.
And it also functions as another facilitator in the relationship between other institutions and Cape Verde.
É por isso que, em nome do governo de Cabo Verde,
and therefore, in the name of the government of Cape Verde,
creio dar parabéns a Bridgewater State University.
I want to congratulate Bridgewater State University
for the launching of this Center of Studies of Cape Verdean
Studies.
E universidade.
And I thank the university
por todo o interesse e toda a amizade que tem demonstrado em relação a Cape Verde.
For all the interest and the friendship it has demonstrated to Cape Verde.
Creio que nos está criando uma base muito forte para nos desenvolver cada vez mais as relações entre a Universidade e Cabo Verde.
I believe that we are building a very strong platform to continue to strengthen this relationship.
E por tudo isso, muito e muito obrigado.
And for all that, thank you. Thank you very much.
And now he did another 5 years, and then we asked him the same question. He did it with a bigger shrug. Ah, incasabe. So after 10 years of incasabe, he's finally done. But he did a wonderful job. We watched him transform Cape Verde. It gives me great honor, and I truly think of him as a friend. I bring to you the honorable former Prime Minister of Cape Verde, José Maria Neche.
Nosso grande amigo de Cabo Verde, Ana Maula Faria,
Israel has a great friend and a friend of Kate Verdine Mulferi.
E também reconheci a presença de embaixador Pan.
And also to recognize the presence of Ambassador Pan.
De senador Pacheco.
Senator Pacheco.
De senador Vini Macedo.
And Senator Vini Macedo.
Representante do governador.
As well as the representative of the governor.
Nosso amigo de universidade e representante de e presidente de Brisco College.
Our friend of the university as well as the president of the Bristol College.
Yeah. E cumprimenta tudo pessoas que estão ali presentes. Cumprimenta o diretor executivo do Instituto, Pedro Pires, pastor Cabo Verdeanos, e também Luísa Gonçalves.
As well as the director of the Institute, Pedro Pires, and also Luísa Gonçalves.
E cumprimenta tudo pessoas que estão ali com um grande abraço.
And also to say, to greet everyone that's here with an embrace.
E destaca a presença do Sr. Embaixador de Cabo Verde na Washington e antigo Primeiro-Ministro de Cabo Verde, Dr. Carlos Veiga.
And I also would like to highlight the presence of the Ambassador of Cape Verde in the United States, Mr. Carlos Veiga.
E antigo Primeiro-Ministro.
And also our former Prime Minister.
E para mim é uma grande honra poder estar ali presente nessa cerimónia de inauguração do Instituto, Pedro Pires, Pastor dos Cabo Verdeanos.
For me, it's a great honor to be here present for the launching of the Institute of Cape Verdean Studies.
Bem, visitei a Universidade de Bridgewater State University em 2002.
I came to visit the University of Bridgewater State University in 2002.
E tive o primeiro encontro com Dana Faria.
And that was my first meeting with Dana Mulferi.
E a perguntar ao Primeiro-Ministro o que é necessário fazer para a ex-Universidade Jura Cabo Verde.
And he asked me during that meeting, Prime Minister, what can Bridgewater State University do to help Cape Verde?
E Efraim, ele é a descendente de Cabo Real, ele gostava de saudar a dívida também para o Cabo Verde.
And at the time he told me he was a descendant of Cape Verdeans and he would like to pay his debt to Cape Verde.
E me falou que a melhor maneira de ajudar Cabo Verde era ajudar a nós temos uma universidade.
I told him at the time that the best way to help Cape Verde is to help us have a university.
E desde essa altura, Bridgewater State University, sob liderança de Dana Faria.
And since then,
de, claro, faz o impossível para que Cabo Verde tivesse uma universidade pública.
And since then, Bridgewater State University, under the leadership of Dr. Dana Mulferi, as well as Dr. Clark, they have done everything possible for Cape Verde to have its university.
Que tem nem palavras, nem medalhas que eu consegui expressar tudo gratidão de Cabo Verde para esse grandioso trabalho que Bridgewater State University faz no nosso país.
There are no words or medals that accurately express the gratitude and all the things that Bridgewater State University has done for our country.
Hoje, Cabo Verde é um símbolo de orgulho de Mostubo, da Residila e tudo que se reside na 11ª ilha, que é Massachusetts.
today in Cambridge. This is a symbol of pride and also for everybody who lives in Massachusetts.
Ontem, que a conversa que teve ali na universidade entre Presidente Pires e antigo Primeiro-Ministro Carlos Veiga e a mim é uma prova de avanço, de maturidade e de desenvolvimento político e institucional de Cabo Verde.
Yesterday we had a conversation here at the university between Comandante Pedro Pires and the Ambassador Carlos Veiga, as well as myself. This is actually proof of the maturity, the political maturity and the advancements that we have made.
E Cabo Verde hoje é país de desenvolvimento, país de rendimento médio.
Today, Cape Verde is a country of medium development.
E é entre os três países mais bem governados de África.
And it is within, between the three countries most well governed in Africa.
Eu fui o primeiro país africano e o segundo país do mundo que conclui o primeiro compacto de Millennium Challenge Account.
And it was the first country in Africa and the second country in the world that concluded the second Millennium Account.
The first.
The first.
E foi o primeiro país do mundo a conseguir um segundo compacto do Millennium Challenge Account.
And it was the first country in the world to attain the second compact of the Millennium Challenge.
Cabo Verde também é dos poucos países do mundo que consegue realizar todos os objetivos de desenvolvimento do milênio.
And also Cape Verde is one of the few countries that has been able to attain all of the requirements of the millennium.
E hoje Cabo Verde fica em casa cada vez mais grande.
And today Cape Verde is becoming an even bigger house.
E casa grande tem que ter grandes alicerces.
And a big house must have strong foundation.
E hoje, para nos orgulho de ter entre nós homem que esteve a colocar as primeiras pedras na alicerce dessa grande casa que é Cáfer.
And today we have among us one of the first men who began building that foundation.
E que seria e nunca tinha nada de mais justo que não cria esse novo ponto que te liga Cabo Verde a Estados Unidos também.
And there would be nothing more just than to build this bridge that connects United States to Cape Verde.
Que Instituto Pedro Pires para
which is the institute, the Pedro Pires Institute for the Cape Verdean Studies.
E tem ali uma riqueza enorme. Cabo Verdeanos é o primeiro povo que chega aos Estados Unidos, primeiro povo africano que chega aos Estados Unidos livremente.
And it's worthy of noting, and this is very rich, is the fact that the Cape Verdean people are the first African people to arrive in the United States under being free.
E que ali é uma referência enorme para não continuar a trabalhar para reforçar essa relação entre os dois países.
And this puts in reference, in regard, that we must continue to work between the friendship of the two countries.
Cabo Verde e Estados Unidos têm a comunga de conjunto de valores que é caros para a humanidade.
Gayford and the United States share in values that are important for the United.
Liberdade.
Freedom.
Cabo Verdeano é um amante incondicional de liberdade.
Cape Verdeans are unconditional lovers of freedom.
Democracia.
Democracy.
Obama. Obama flavismo na democracia nunca encontra remédios para tudo desafios que nunca encontram na sociedade mulher.
Obama said not too long ago that in democracy you find the medicine for all the challenges that you may find in modern society.
Cabo-verdianos é um amante incondicional da democracia.
And Cape Verdeans are also lovers, unconditional lovers of democracy.
E cabo-verdianos têm finalmente uma outra grande ânsia.
Oh, and Cape Verdeans also have the desire
que Estados Unidos realize que nós ainda não
that the United States has concretized, has realized, and we are still trying to do that.
Que desenvolvimento.
Which is development.
E esse grande sonho para realizar com certeza no futuro.
And this dream will come true in the future.
E com os grandes alicerces colocados com os grandes homens, Mário Pedro Pires, não consigo efetivamente realizar esse sonho de desenvolvimento.
E com as fundações that was begun by this great man Pedro Pires, we will attain development.
E portanto, agradeço mais uma vez Bridgewater State University para esse trabalho cintilante. Brilhante que tem feito para Cabo Verde.
So once more I would like to thank Bridgewater State University for the work it has done for Cape Verde.
E seguindo exemplo de Pedro Pires, toda continua a trabalhar de sol a sol, todo dia, para que Cabo Verde fique mais grande e chegue cada vez mais perto de América.
And following the example that Bill Pierce has set, we will continue to work from dawn to dusk so Cape Verde can look more like the United States.
E longa vida Instituto Pedro Pires para Estudos Cabo-Verdeanos.
May the Institute have a long life.
E muito sucesso, muitas felicidades para o Bridgewater State University.
And much success and congratulations to Bridgewater State University.
E para que Cabo Verde e Estados Unidos e continua de cada um dentro de suas possibilidades a que amanhã não tenha uma humanidade cada vez melhor.
And may Cape Verde and the United States continue to work so tomorrow we can have a humanity that's much greater.
Thank you very much.
Cape Verdean, one more trip, I'm glad about that. I had realized
that this region is the 11th island of Cape Verde, because we are the 11th island. So I have come to realize the importance of Cape Verde in this region, at this institution, and I have grown not only respect, but also a love of Cape Verde because of Dana. And what he didn't tell me, though, is that what else I'd be surprised at is its relevance to my own family. Because it was just a couple of months ago that we discovered that my wife's grandmother, her father was from Brava. And he was actually buried in Brava, and of course, President Molaferri's family is from Brava, and I think our state senator is from Brava. I'm sorry, Mike. Mike's the only person here from Cobo. And actually, my son just got married about a month ago, and his wife is half Cape Verdean also, so Cape Verde is very relevant in my family. I just didn't realize it until I became president. I am very proud. Everything that we have done at Bridgewater State or that we will do in Cape Verde in terms of this partnership, everything began with President Molaferri. We all at this university stand on his shoulders. I say that to him all the time. We will build on the foundation that he left us. I am so proud of him. I am so proud to have succeeded him. He didn't just leave me with a kind of a work ethic for Cape Verde. He wanted me to have a love for the partnership, and I do. And that really comes directly from him. It's an example of how this institution feels about that partnership. Dana's legacy continues. And I want to make an announcement before he comes up here, because a couple of days ago we talked about some funds that were raised previously in the name of his parents, John and Francis. And we raised hundreds of thousands of dollars in the years that Dana was president, but those funds were not obligated, they weren't dedicated. So in conversations with Vice President Malife and with Dana, $300,000 of those funds, beginning today, will be purposed, and I want to get this right, to support scholars and or initiatives the Pedro Perez Institute for Cape Verdean Studies. Yeah. And thank you, Dan, for building that foundation and for your continuing legacy. We love you. President Dana Molaferri.
When you lead an institution like Bridgewater, or any organization, one of the things that you begin to think about as you near the end of the twilight of your time in office is that, you know, what's going to happen? It's not so much about legacy and what people are going to think about you, but what's going to happen to the institution, to this university going forward? And I will tell you, there is no one that understands this institution, its potential, and the directions that it has, the avenues that are possible for it. No one more than Fred Clark. And I will tell you, I could be happier that he is my successor. I love this guy. He's just amazing. And as he says, been to Cape Verde 7 times and has a love for Cape Verde, and it's just great. So Fred, just thank you for being who you are and where you are. Very kind of thank you. So Prime Minister Nehru talked about 2002, and I believe it was in this room that we had a conversation, and he had been visiting, and there was somewhat of an event. We had a conversation about the relationship between Bridgewater and Cape Verde. And I was only the second Cape Verdean president of a college or university, and actually the first of a four-year institution in America. And his recognition of the potential and the possibility with this institution and this region was great. It sparked that conversation, which led to a number of engagements over the years. And I will tell you, I did not have the opportunity to work with Prime Minister Vega, nor did I work directly when Pedro Pierce was Prime Minister, but I did work for the entire tenure of my presidency. Our tenures were in parallel. He was Prime Minister the entire time that I was president. And I just tell you, Prime Minister Nehru, that the work that you've done to transform Cape Verde from my first visit in 2005 until recently has been nothing short of miraculous. You have changed the lives of thousands, hundreds of thousands of people in Cape Verde and here. And for that, we will always be indebted to you. So Mike asked me to just speak a bit about how this institute came to be and what was the conceptual framework and the thought that went into to developing this. And it really, after the engagement had gone on for a while, Mike and I were on a plane coming back from Cape Verde. You may not remember this conversation, Mike, and it was Mike who said, you know, this relationship, we need to think about this. This is so important to the university and to Cape Verde. How do we institutionalize it? And so Mike, and if you know Mike, as you know, he can really talk. So he talked to me the whole flight. Even when I was sleeping, he was still talking. But he really planted that seed, which caused me to think of it, and then we had conversations back and forth, and from those conversations came this concept of developing this institute that would be a hub for everything Cape Verdean in America. How can we develop this institute that would be one of a kind, that would not only institutionalize it here at this university, but create opportunity and access for better knowledge and understanding about Cape Verde and Cape Verdeans. So we did, as Mike said, put together a committee of people, many of them here tonight, to really begin to really work through this and help to understand what this might look like and what it might be. And they did present that to me, and we had several iterations of it, and realized that it was ready to go, and we began to move forward. Now you might ask, why has this institute been in place for 2 years and just being launched this evening? Well, I will tell you, When we developed the Institute, we recognized that this was for the long haul. This was something that was going to matter, and that it would take time to really develop, to become the kind of institute that we wanted. And before we could really launch, we needed to create a foundation. We needed to hire a director. We needed to do a number of things to put in place before we could launch. And so we did. I was I'll tell you where I was. I just left the Council of Presidents meeting, or those meetings, and I was driving back and I was thinking, I was on the phone with someone about Cape Verde, and as I hung up the phone, I was thinking about the Institute, and I thought, well, we know what we want it to be, and how do we create the symbolic optic of this Institute? What is it that we do? And I thought about that for a long time. And I realized that it really embodied, everything that Pedro Cruz stood for. And I came back and I asked, I think it was Mike, the first person I talked to, and I said, we're going to name this the Pedro Cruz Institute for Cape Verdean Studies. And we did. This gentleman, Pedro Cruz, is I had the honor one evening with a small group of people to really listen to him talk about the move for independence in some detail. And we were in a small room at a hotel and we were having this conversation and I was mesmerized. And it was an epiphany for me at that moment because I realized who I was in the room with. This is one, not only of the greatest Cape Verdeans that ever has lived, but one of the greatest human beings on this earth. And they recognized that in Africa by awarding him the Mohegan Award for his work in services meeting and the creation of democracy. So that's how we came to name this institute. And we are so proud to have your name on it, President Pierce, because you symbolize everything we stand for. Well, one of the things, and it's always kind of embarrassing to hear people talk about it and give you credit for this, but I want to say something, I want you all to know this, and before I say this, I want to ask Mike Gomes to come up here. Come up here. You're my boss, but I'm telling you, come up here. So, in this time, over the years from 1995 really, until 2 years ago, year and a half ago, as this initiative came underway, there was a voice. There was a power, there was a passion that existed right by my side, and that was this guy. He drove me crazy. With every turn he would be advocating for this development of this relationship. He had his own job to do, but he did this work also. Those of you who are here at the university will recognize this. All of the students who came from Cape Verde to study here were guided by Mike. Every single one of them. In fact, that's why they call him Papa Mike. Because he has done that work, and so as you sort of graciously give accolades, I want you to know that this guy deserves some major credit for all his work. I also want to recognize podium, and that is my wife Kathy, who's here, who prepped with me all those years, running all over the place. My sister Elaine. She was the wife of my favorite uncle. I loved him. In fact, my dissertation is dedicated to him. But that's my aunt, Dolores Solo.
Okay with me.
accident. So things like this don't happen by accident. So thank you, Dana. Thank you, Fred, for your continued support to Cape Verde. At this time, what I'd like to do is I'd like to bring up Joao Rosa, who is the director of the Institute, to introduce a video for you. Thank you.
Colleagues, welcome to everyone. A very big welcome to our international friends who came over to celebrate with us the launching of the Institute for Cape Verdean Studies. I'm going to be introducing a video in a second that's going to talk to you a little bit about the Institute. I want us to very quickly acknowledge all the friends and collaborators of the Institute, folks who have given of themselves to make sure that the Institute thrives. I think of particularly the folks who put the Institute together, the folks who work on the organizing committee for this event. I have to tell you that the Institute always works in a collaborative format, always. And Vice President Gomes and President Emeritus Dr. David Mofaria spoke a little bit about the notion of serving. The Institute is about serving. And in my view, the Institute has an ethical and moral responsibility to be a bridge between the past and the future. It works in the present, but the idea is to bridge the past and the future. We want to make sure that the legacy, the cultural, historical legacy of Cape Verdeans is here to stay. It's here to be shared with everyone who wants to learn and understand about Cape Verde. Amilcar Cabral has a very famous saying that he said that culture is simultaneously the fruit of a people's history and a determinant of that history. Our job is to make sure that everyone understands that history. To all of the friends who have collaborated with the Institute, we have someone who came here from Portugal today, we have people from Cape Verde, we have friends from all over. I tell you, a heartfelt thank you for all your support, your continuing support of the Institute. When I was young, I witnessed the arrival of President Aristides Pereira in Cape Verde. I was a little kid, went with my father to the airport, watched this new president come in, and the people were so excited, they were shaking the cars couldn't move, there was so much turmoil and so forth. It was an image that stayed in my mind to this day. And it's a wonderful image to have because it's a foundation of where I came from. And from my perspective, the Institute has an ethical and moral responsibility to make sure that that history, all of our histories, are known and share with everyone. So I thank you very much for coming down. I thank you for supporting the Institute. And I have to tell you that that support has to be continuous. And I'm hoping that you can engage with the Institute in the future. We've prepared a little video for you to see about some of the projects of the Institute. Now granted, we don't have all the projects. Well, for example, the summer leadership program is not there, a few other programs are not there. But it will give you a taste of what it is that the Institute is involved in. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the evening and enjoy the video. Thank you very much.
My name is Sean Hauser. I'm the Executive Director of the Bill Fish Institute for Cape Verdean Studies at Bridgewater State University. We welcome you to this celebration.
The Institute really grew from the need to
to preserve the Cape Verdean culture, to really tell the Cape Verdean story in a different way than it's been told in the past.
We needed to develop in the institution some entity, some organization that would formalize that relationship, that would be an institute based in scholarship and community engagement, as well as engagement with Cape Verde, that would continue to foster that and grow that relationship and create opportunities for our students here, for people in the community, for people from Cape Verde. And that was the real intent of the institute.
But I would make the argument that it benefits the student body at Bridgewater State University significantly.
We've recently had the unique pleasure of doing the logistical coordination for a legislative trip to Cape Verde.
And the exchange with elected officials, being prior to being full-growing or whatever, was wonderful to see that connection, and I think that brings the ability for us to come back and look for other opportunities to engage. And I think we walked away, both us and those who participated in the National Parliament with that discussion. We walked away with really a much more knowledgeable way of looking at things.
Planning around the trip was extremely well done. The opportunity to engage directly with members of the assembly, with the leadership, was a tremendous opportunity.
The most enriching part of the trip for me was the connection with Bridgewater and the nexus with New Bedford, and of course brought in other Cape Verdean communities in Massachusetts and Rhode Island. Bridgewater has dedicated the resources, and for me, it, a lot of it is respect.
We've had the unique pleasure of collaborating with Dr. Amina Pilgrim of the University of Massachusetts at Boston to develop an oral history project in which we collect, document, and archive the experiences and the histories of elders in our community.
I started doing oral histories as a part of my PhD research at Rutgers. The Institute gave me a space to kind of rebirth the oral history project in a powerful way. Cape Verdeans of all ages, you know, are part of this oral history project, which preserves our stories in our words, restores some of the agency that maybe has been lost by other people telling our stories. And through delving into multiple subjects and themes, the Oral History Project is creating an archive, which will be a digital archive that can be preserved and used for generations, you know, so that our children and our grandchildren can come and listen to our voices. Dr. Rosa and I were fortunate enough to interview Mary Rose, who's a beloved centenarian in Onset, Massachusetts. And at over 100 years old, she probably is more of a historian than some people with PhDs.
Strawberries, that's how we have buried it, because in some ways, I had this papiola. This thing to carry berries in.
I mean, we wouldn't have a whaling industry without the Cape Verdean sacrifice. And yet all of that history for decades was taught as a white owner's history.
It takes an act of courage, an act of faith, and an act of commitment to your family, because the impetus for them moving was to better the lives of their families.
Understanding history, understanding our past in that way gives us different perspectives. So it begins to destroy the myth that Cape Verdeans arrived when, you know, Massachusetts became the cranberry capital of the world and arrived to pick cranberries. That's not so. I think for us to really understand the issues that we are faced with today, the opportunities, the challenges, we've got to understand who we are.
And so if we are able, as an educational institution, to create and provide those kinds of opportunities and to preserve legacies so that we understand the past, its connection to the present, and the opportunity and challenges it creates for the future, that's critically important.
That oral history is a rich history because it gives you a sense of where you came from. There's an old saying, if you don't know where you came from, you don't know where you're going.
No matter where we come from, no matter what our race or ethnicity, or gender or perspective on things, is to really understand better who we are. That allows us in the long run to create better communities.
The Emilio Cabral Lecture Series was a unique concept. And basically what it is that every month or every other month we invite academics from all over the U.S. And some have actually come from outside the U.S. to do specific talks on topics that affect Cape Verdean experiences, whether it's the transnationality of Cape Verdean experiences, the multiplicity of identities, culture, art, history, music, covering a broad range of topics.
So I think it's really important that there is an available space where intellectuals can come together to discuss, to think about, to talk, to debate issues that are uniquely Cape Verdean. I think it's vital. There's nothing like it that I know of elsewhere. So where does this take place if not here in this institute on this campus?
Bringing somebody like Joe in from a culture that really, really believes in art, and it's a foundation that, you know, singing, dance, I mean, there's this belief and faith, I think is important to introduce that, you know, art by itself is good for you. And when I was putting the show up this week, people were stopping before they were even on the wall and taking pictures and asking me about the artist.
At the Pedro Pierce Institute for Cape Verdean Studies, we are extremely proud of the development of our yearly International Conference on Cape Verdean Studies.
It was an honor to be a part of the planning committee for the inaugural Cape Verdean Studies Conference. We had a really strong team that brought a lot of passion and energy to the project.
I was also amazed at the commitment of the people on the organizing committee. They were very, very dedicated people.
We're coming up to the third iteration of that. It's been a privilege, and I feel the same spirit of generosity and exchange and optimism on the part of the committee members who are drawn from different institutions, different locations in our New England region.
And being part of such a big conference was a big thing. I learned a lot from it.
I'm not Cape Verdean, but I've spent a lot of time in Cape Verdean studying and read and did research in Cape Verde. But to be with, for a weekend, with an entire group of people for whom Cape Verde was really part of their heart and soul was a fascinating experience.
The Journal of Cape Verdean Studies is a collaboration that the Pedro Pierce Institute for Cape Verdean Studies developed with Pedagogical Press of Europe. And basically, the journal is a biannual journal, academic journal, that focuses on the transnationality of the Cape Verdean experience.
Having a place to publish your work on Cape Verdean studies is a really powerful thing for an academic such as myself, who maybe struggled to find places that would accept work on our community. So there's definitely the academic impact.
One of the things that I was able to do by being faculty here was I was able to do a year-long research presidential fellowship in Cape Verde. And I studied reading instruction across all nine inhabited islands. 2,000 surveys, 116 interviews with teachers, that ability, I think, stems in large part to this university's commitment to the Cape Verde Diaspora and Cape Verde Newport. And I think this institute is central to that commitment. So it's vital to have a space like this where intellectuals, where academics, where anyone can come and share research, knowledge, questions about Cape Verde in ways that haven't been done in the past.
Unlike most academic institutions that focus mostly on research and theory, one of the unique aspects of our institute, an aspect that we are extremely proud of, is the fact that not only do we engage the research and the theory components, but we also focus on the community. So the community forums, for example, is a clear illustration or clear demonstration of this.
Some of the particular social issues that we've tackled through the institute, such as youth violence, school-to-prison pipeline, forthcoming domestic violence event, I think all of those also reflect how the institute is making an impact in the wider community that we're all a part of, the human community, if you will, and just the global diaspora.
We have a strong community, the Cape community in this region, in the New England area. We have our mark in this community.
And it goes beyond just that. I mean, the talks that the Institute has held make an impact, providing a space for academic dialogue, but also providing a space for community members to learn about the work that we do and interact with scholars, so there's no divide between the community outside of the so-called ivory tower and inside.
So the music documentary project was a project in which we had to travel to Cape Verde several times to interview composers, musicians, artists, music promoters, music engineers, and so forth, to get a better understanding of Cape Verdean music as a whole.
Moi, j'aimerais surtout le bac et musique cadre de la musique française et l'identité de notre pays.
Música de Fluxi, no momento onde a descarga está a procurar formas de comunicação.
To grow into a national organization, really becoming the hub for everything Cape Verde in the U.S. in terms of history and documentation and research and that kind of effort.
The Institute just professionalizes everything and is a sign of Bridgewater State's commitment to the Cape Verdean community.
The Institute will create a space in where where the university or region can really begin to interact around issues to do with the Cape Verdean community, the culture, the diaspora here, and with the Cape Verdean people back in Cape Verde as well.
At the core of it is that connection with Cape Verde.
Yeah, taking a history course is as important as taking an English course, as taking a course in Cape Verdean studies. I think that they're all a way for a student to become a well-rounded individual.
Even the Creole language. I mean, these are things that need to be preserved for future generations. I look at myself, and I have, you know, my children, and the challenge of being able to teach them the language that I grew up with is very difficult because of not having that. And I know that Bridgewater State, that's a priority to them. They are making a way that my child, you know, may have an opportunity to know the language that I grew up in.
When I talk to other people and I ask them, like, what are they, where are they from? And I tell them that I'm from Cape Verde, they say, where is Cape Verde?
Being a student here at Bridgewater State University and being Cape Verdean means everything to me because I'm bringing a part of my name to Bridgewater. making the Bridgewater community more diverse, and I'm giving students another another aspect of different cultures and different ideas. And I feel like it makes me feel more at home when I have a part of my home being brought into the university, and it also shows how much Bridgewater cares about how Cape Verdean students feel and how much they're welcomed into the Bridgewater community.
The Institute eliminates the idea of isolation, with isolation and feeling lonely off campus, along with CBSA.
To be a Cape Verdean here at Bridgewater State University is just showing the proudness of where I came from. I can think like a Cape Verdean, but I can also wrap their ideas and mix it together and come up with like a greater thing.
Knowing the significance of the Cape Verdean community in the Southeast Massachusetts region, having an institution like Bridgewater that appreciates that and has reached out to that community specifically is so important. And you've seen, and I think if you look over the last 10, 15 years, you've seen people in the Cape Verdean community have a significant appreciation for the fact that here we have a state school that has paid such interest or shown such interest in our Cape Verdean culture and what it's meant for this region.
It was a firm commitment to a very, very, very important population in Massachusetts. Because of the Institute, they know there's a grand opportunity.
It has been for quite some time, and so to be able to continue to have these relationships that are very important not only for us as an institution but for the region, we are going to have to rely on external funding. We want to be able to provide our students with access to study tours, to be able to go to Cape Verde. We want to be able to provide students with language courses. We want to eventually be able to provide students with a certificate program here, and then grow that to also include a bachelor's degree. And so all of that requires funding. Private resources are going to be crucial to make all of these things available for our students.
Bridgewater has become a leader in many ways in its international engagement. And as we think about the communities that surround us, and we think about the work that we need to do in understanding the broader community, and I don't mean just the Cape Verdean community, but just the broader communities that are around us, it provides an opportunity for our faculty and our students to explore the relationship, to understand better what culture means, to understand more around issues of immigration, to really begin to understand a lot of what is going on in our country. And I think this is a microcosmic way of really fostering that kind of thinking.
It makes me very happy and very proud as a state senator to support a public institution that is giving that much back to our community.
If we can give assistance, we are here to help.
I mean, how can I not be more than just proud? I mean, I am just, as someone who was born in the island of Rob, to know that a state institution has paid such respect to the Cape Verdean, Cape Verdean culture and the Cape Verdean community, and put together an institute like this. And I have to give credit and thanks to our own Dana Mogafaria, for his commitment to the Cape Verdean community, what he has done with that, and frankly, to have the new president come in and share that exact same commitment and keep that legacy alive, makes me incredibly proud as a Cape Verdean, and frankly, all Cape Verdeans should be proud of what's happening here in Bridgewater, because I believe that there's a legacy here that is going to go on for generations because of this commitment.
That's his nickname. Numi Gus. At this time, it's my distinct honor, and I think it's really our distinct honor, to hear from the person for whom the Institute is named, for Pedro Pish. You heard the accolades. There can't be enough accolades for him, for a man who's dedicated his entire life to Cape Verde. Being Prime Minister for 16 years, being President for 9 years, Jacques told me something. He said that when he was looking through his papers, he saw a picture of him when he was a freedom fighter, and he looked like a little boy, just a little boy. And because he's been in this struggle for such a long time, so without any further ado, I'd like to bring to the podium the Honorable, the Commander, the Prime Minister, the President, Pedro Pich.
E capacidade de comunicação. for his introduction and his capacity to communicate. And for all of you, good evening.
Hoje me senti honrado duas vezes. Honrado para Salinhos, honrado para Nustana Cerimónia e a apresentação pública de instituto que tem minha nome.
So tonight I'm doubly honored. I'm honored to be here with you, and I'm honored to be launching with you, to be launching the institute that carries my name.
E é uma honra grande, mas também é uma responsabilidade grande.
This is a great honor, but also is great responsibility.
Me obrigado a ter uma postura, um comportamento, uma atitude que te honra o Instituto também.
In reality, I must have a behavior and an attitude that also honors the Institute.
Talvez que me na época perguntasse para o museu, para a memória de cabo-verdeanos nos Estados Unidos da América.
So every time I came to the United States, I asked about museums or the memories of Cape Verdeans in the United States.
E esteve num museu interessante, né? East Providence.
I went to a museum, an interesting museum in East Providence.
Por que é interessante? Porque tinha vontade de olhar fotografia de barco que se chamava Carolianos, que fazia a ligação América-Cabo Verde e que tinha quarto de primeira de diversas categorias, inclusive tinha quarto de primeira classe que havia entrado ali na barco da Vela de Cabo Verde.
So, why do I call it interesting museum? It was interesting because I've always wanted to see pictures of a vessel called Carolianos, and this vessel used to connect Cape Verde to the United States. And it had different rooms, like first class and second class.
It is a museum in East Providence que encontra uma fotografia ou desenho de maioria de barcos que fazia ligação entre Estados Unidos e Cabo Verde.
And in this museum I found several pictures and drawings of vessels that actually made this connection.
Museu de Baleia, na New Bedford, tem uma sala dedicada a Cabo Verdeano.
And the Whaling Museum in New Bedford has a room solely dedicated to the Cape Verdeans.
E, quer dizer, elemento importante de nossa memória, de memória de Cabo Verdeanos na Estados Unidos da América.
These are important elements of the history of Cape Verdeans in the United States of America.
Se não pensa que Cabo Verdeanos começa a emigrar para a América no princípio do século XVIII, quer dizer, no princípio de 1700 e pouco, chega à conclusão que deve ter uma memória grande desse.
So, if we conclude that Cape Verdeans began coming to America around the 1700 then we know that there must be a long history.
Mas também, se não pensar que viagem de Cabo Verde para América leva entre 30 e 40 dias.
But also we must be reminded that a trip to the United States...
Claro, na barco velha, porque no avião é 7 horas.
Takes about 30 to 40 days. But of course, keep in mind that this is in a vessel, because in a plane it's a lot faster.
Mas que chega daquele barco de 6 catechigas. 6 de lhe, catechiga, ou 6 de lá, catechiga mer.
So many of those vessels left Cape Verde and never made it to America, and sometimes they would leave America to Cape Verde and never make it to Cape Verde.
A ligação foi uma grande aventura, mas uma grande decisão.
This connection was a great adventure, but it was also a great decision.
Que ela demonstra espírito de espírito combativo, iniciativa de Cabo Lourenço.
This demonstrates the spirit of struggle as well as the spirit of initiative of Cape Verdeans.
Você fazer a introdução para chegar à conclusão que faltava uma coisa mais existindo.
And in conclusion, we know and now we feel that something was missing, and it was something like this institute.
Instituto por bem completa, que está falta para conhecimento de presença de Cabo Verdeanos ali nos Estados Unidos da América.
So this institute completes what was missing in order to document the presence.
Mas também a ligação entre Cabo Verde, Estados Unidos, Cabo Verde.
But also the connection between Cape Verde and United States and United States and Cape Verde.
Para mim, a ligação entre Cabo Verde e Estados Unidos da América, ou entre Cabo Verde e América, mas não está claro.
So for me, the connection between Cape Verde and United States
é que ele depende do governo de Cabo Verde.
Does not depend on the government of Cape Verde.
Cabo Verdeanos é tomado para ser conta.
Cape Verde
e Cabo Verdeanos se fazer.
Cape Verdeans themselves have taken this to themselves. It's
the
Cape Verdeans that are making it.
É para fazer parte de forma de Cabo Verde, de Cabo Verdeanos para o mundo.
So this is very much a part of the Cape Verdeans and the belonging of Cape Verdeans.
Outrora, ora quem quer perguntar para um amigo, nunca se vê sempre perguntado, né, está na Cabo Verde ou está na América?
Sometimes when I speak to my friends, I don't know what to ask them. Are you in Cape Verde or are you in the United States?
Porque tanto alguém que está saindo lá para mim ali, vem para ali, pronto, pronto, está lá, há de encontrar com o senhor, perguntar para seu marido.
Because there are so many people that come and go that you never know where a person is at one time.
O marido, por exemplo, o seu nome é um segredo, porque o governador está lá de base. Perguntar, o governador, onde é que está?
So, I meant
to say... O governador deve ficar na América.
So, I meant to say that I asked her, where's your husband?
Essa dá uma ideia de grau de ligação de Cabo Verde tem com o médico.
And he's the governor of Asia. And she told me, no, he's in the United States. This gives you an idea, the connection between Cape Verde and the United States.
Ora, que o Japa é sala.
When I look at this room,
tudo aqui,
and I see everybody here,
ainda pensando, mas é de fato um terra especial.
I think the United States is in fact a very special country.
Cabo Verdeanos ali, tudo integrado, está ali tudo junto, está ali
estuda
na universidade, está ali atividade econômica normal, portanto, um terra
especial.
Não pode falar que Cabo Verdeanos, então, da partilha com o americano, é sempre sonho do americano.
So we can say that
American dream.
Truly share this American dream.
Nós,
we?
Agradecimento para a América, para esta terra, para seu povo, é esse facto de permitir que a Verdeanos partilhe com ele esse sonho americano.
So we thank this country for allowing the Verdeans to come over and share the American dream.
No outro outro mês, é Instituto. A importância desse instituto é o que é que ele pode fazer na área de cultura.
So let's return to talking about the institute. The importance of the institute is what it can do for culture.
América é um país de grande diversidade cultural.
It's true that the United States is a country of great cultural diversity.
História.
Of history.
Não no presente conhecer na história, não precisa saber de onde é que ele vem. Mas para mim, mais importante de nossa história é a nossa capacidade de resistência e nossa teimosia para existir.
So we know from history exactly where we came from, but for me the most important part in our history is our capacity to resist, our resilience, and our desire to exist.
Para pouco que tem na Cabo Verde, para dificuldade que cabreamos passando essa história, para tudo tragédia que o povo cabreano passa.
For the little bit that we have in Cape Verde, for all the tragedies and the challenges that Cape Verdeans have survived.
Percebe, usa que hoje, que ele tem uma grande capacidade de resistência, ele tem uma grande fé, ele tem uma grande teimosia de existir.
So for Cape Verde to be what it is now, given this history, it's because it's truly resilient and it has a great desire to exist.
Esse nosso resistência, esse nosso teimosia de existir, que o Instituto também trabalha lado de história e lado de cultura.
So this resilience and the stubbornness and this need to exist, is where I know the Institute will work with in this history.
Instituto, poder fazer uma outra coisa, que é ser focal point, para um ponto de concentração para relações entre universidades americanas ou universitários americanos e Cabo Verde.
But the Institute can also be a focal point in the connection of academics and academic institutions in
tem,
America and Cape Verde.
Tem geo competência cabo-verdiana na América.
There are much Cape Verdean expertise in the United States, and this expertise can be very valuable to
Cabo Verde. Cabo Verde precisa dessa competência, precisa dessa capacidade.
Cape Verde needs this capacity, this level of expertise.
Então, o Instituto pode canalizar.
So the Institute can actually bring us this.
Porque também uma outra coisa que tem na cabeça é que ela é tem de organização no mundo para combater HIV-Sida, fome, seca, desertificação.
So, the other thing that I think about is there are many organizations in the world to combat HIV, hunger, poverty.
Mas se não crê acabar com miséria no mundo, se não crê acabar com tragédia, tudo que tem no mundo, só tem uma maneira de fazer de um ponto de vista.
So if we want to end poverty and end tragedy, that's only one way to do it in my view.
Só tem uma maneira de fazer, apostar na formação, na educação.
We must bet.
Não pensa se a ONU decide avançar um projeto ou um programa de eliminação de ignorância, de desconhecimento e para avançar com o desenvolvimento de tecnologia no mundo, da mesma forma que luta contra a HIV-Sida.
So, we must think about something like ONU that developed a project to eliminate poverty and to begin development. We need to think of something like that to eliminate HIV.
Partilha de conhecimento, transferência de conhecimento, solidariedade na área de conhecimento é fundamental para não vencer pobreza, para não vencer ignorância, para não vencer atraso, para não ter um mundo mais aberto e mais dialogante.
So the sharing and the transference of knowledge is fundamental to this development. It's important to have an open world.
E não olhar filmes sobre institutos.
And we saw a documentary about the institute.
Nos está impressionado com tudo esse determinação, tudo essa ideia para fazer esse instituto avançar.
And truly impressed with all the determination and all the ideas to make the Institute move forward.
Por isso, eu quero agradecer de todo o coração a Dana Faria, Presidente Emérito.
So we thank you from the bottom of my heart, President Dana Faria.
Mike Gomes, eu quero agradecer o Presidente Frederick Clark.
We also thank President Frederick Clark.
Porque ele pega a bandeira do Instituto. Uma bandeira do Instituto está levada para frente com grande determinação e carinho.
So Dana said, take the flag. He has carried the flag with great determination and great care.
Nós queremos felicitar João Rosa para também aquilo que ele fazer, mas sobretudo para ser empenho, para ser dedicação, para fazer avançar o Instituto.
And we congratulate João Rosa for his determination as well as his efforts in helping the Institute.
Eu quero agradecer a todos os seus colaboradores, que seu nome vem ali, né? Não é já.
And we thank all the collaborators.
Para seus empenhos, para seus colaboração, mas também para esse desejo de fazer avançar o Instituto e o Instituto ser entidade que poder receber contributo de tudo alguém ali na América e tudo cabo-verdeanos ali na América.
We thank all the collaborators of the Institute for the effort, the determination, and the desire to make the Institute come forth and make the Institute be the under the mission that you have.
De minha parte, ainda comprometer fazer tudo que está em alcance para sucesso do Instituto.
And for me, I will do everything I can for the success of this Institute.
Mas o Instituto só pode ter sucesso se é trabalho, você objetivo de seu alguém. Por exemplo, tu não está em sala.
But the Institute can only be successful with the work and the collaboration of many people, like the people here in the room.
Meu desejo é que nós da Instituto esse apoio pelo menos ser uma grande instituição cabo-verdiano-americana ali na Massachusetts.
And my desire is that you all give your support to the Institute so it can become a great institution, a great agency of the Cape Verdean America.
Porque o Instituto é cá só de Bridgewater State University. É de história de Cabo Verde, é de cultura de Cabo Verde, é de cabo-verdianos.
Because the Institute does not only belong to Bridgewater State University, it is in fact, it belongs to the history and the culture, it belongs to Cape Verdeans.
Mas também é de americanos.
But it also belongs to the Americans.
Cabo-verdiano, comunidade cabo-verdiana na América também é americana.
Because the Cape Verdean community United States is also American.
É importante que nós tenhamos essa visão ali.
It's very important to have this vision.
Para terminar, porque eu sei que você deve estar cansado.
And to end, because I know you must be tired.
Eu quero desejar grande sucesso ao Instituto Pedro Pires Sul dos Cabo-Verdeanos.
We hope a great success for the Institute of Cape Verdean Studies.
Muita felicidade. Bridgewater State University para essa iniciativa e, sobretudo, para esse desejo de contribuir para o avanço de Cabo Verde, principalmente ser universidade.
And we congratulate Bridgewater State University for this initiative and this desire to contribute to the advancement of the Cape Verde.
Educação é grande arma para transformar tudo terra e para transformar o mundo.
Education is the greatest weapon to transform a nation as well as the world.
Colaboração de Bridgewater State University, a Universidade de Cabo Verde é uma grande arma de transformação de Cabo Verde, mas sobretudo de desenvolvimento de seu ensino universitário.
And the collaboration of Utah State University as well with the University of Cape Verde is a great weapon in the transformation and the development of Cape
Verde. Vou terminar com um grande obrigado.
We will end with a very big thank you.
Longa vida para a Universidade Estatal de Ridgeworth.
May the university have long life.
Longa vida para o Instituto Pedro Pires Passos Cabo-Verdeanos.
And a long life as well for the Institute of Cape Verdean Studies.
E longa vida para a amizade entre o Estado de América e Cabo Verde.
Alex and Miguel Gomes, Jr. Ann, Dana, and Elaine Rose. Representing the Cruz family and their gift in memory of Bertie Cruz, please thank his son, John B. Cruz. In memory of Feliciano Flash Tavares, please join me in thanking his sons, Tiny and Ralph Tavares, who are representing their family. We are also grateful for a recent addition to the family members that is not listed on the program and who were not able to attend the event this evening, but we still want to recognize their generosity and support, the Wright family. Thank you to all of our generous donors and all of you for attending this evening. So thank you, Risha, thank yourselves. I also want to encourage all of you to think about how you may be able to assist with the goals of the Institute. You have met Dr. Joao Rosa, and he is here somewhere. He can use your help in many ways, such as a volunteer, providing needs and connections to those whose oral histories should be collected, or by helping to identify diaries, personal papers, and photographs that can be added to the Institute's collection. You can also become a donor. Any dollar amount helps us reach our $2 million goal in the next 3 years. On your tables, you will see a pledge form. And on that form, you can see that there are multiple options and ways to give. You can give either by filling that out, and if you do so, please leave the form with me, with Lisa, there you are, with Debbie over there, or with Mike Gomes. If you don't want to, aren't able to do that, that's perfectly fine as well. We know that you believe in Bridgewater State University. You wouldn't be here otherwise. So we know that we can count on you, you can be a volunteer, you can assist in any way possible. We know that you will be there for us, and we certainly appreciate anything and everything that you do for us at Bridgewater and for the Institute specifically. Thank you for everything that you have done. Thank you for coming this evening.